8 teams, 8 games, 1 chance at $10,000. Some of the best-known video games started out with one designer and a risky idea. We're looking for one such designer.
We didn't really know what we were getting into. We were complete amateurs.
You build up sort of a creative pressure, and you have to vent it somehow.
I think we are taking chances with the game. Definitely the time it takes and money.
You don't just get handed respect at all being a girl gamer. You have to earn it.
The scariest part of this for me is, will it actually be fun to other people?
Really, the key to success is never giving up.
I put a lot of blood, sweat, and tears into the game. With the family, you kind of have to juggle.
The scariest thing about actually making any kind of game is that it may be the last game that you make.
In round one, 8 designers will go head-to-head each week until 4 are left standing. In order to win, the judges are looking for the game they think you will most want to play.
You've ultimately given us what could be the next great game.
Then they will have 12 hours to improve their game, and that's when it gets even more intense.
It has the potential to be a great-looking game that has nothing else to say for itself.
I don't know anyone who would really be interested in playing. I know I probably wouldn't play it.
What are you trying to communicate?
On to the last round, where it all comes down to 2 finalists.
We've reached a decision, officially.
Then it's your turn. We'll put their 2 games online for you to play and vote on. Which one of these 8 game designers will be the next game boss? Today, it's a battle for space as a sci-fi RPG faces off with a retro side-scroller.
VENABLE!
This is very fun.
Which game has the most potential to be downloaded by the masses?
Oh my gosh, that's cool.
That's fantastic.
And which one goes back to the start menu?
I think it's shitty.
Welcome to the Next Game Boss. I'm Naomi Kyle. 8 indie game designers will have to impress our panel of industry experts. David Jaffe is the outspoken designer of Twisted Metal and the legendary God of War series. David does not hold back, so if our contestants don't bring their A game, he just might go all Kratos on them.
I have the same expectations I have whenever I look at a new game, just, you know, excitement.
Lisa Foyles is a girl who has serious game. She's the lead voice in Twisted Pixel's upcoming game, Loco Cycle.
Eat concrete, punk.
As a columnist for Kotaku and host for the Game Station, she's used to playing and reviewing video games every week.
Today, we will be testing your knowledge of the Assassin's Creed series.
These guys have a blank canvas. They don't have a big multi-million dollar company breathing down their neck to make a specific game. I'm looking for some creativity here.
Known for his highly stylized and emotional games, Genova Chen came along and blew us all away with Cloud, Flow, Flower, and Journey. IGN's 2012 Game of the Year.
I look at these game shows about game making, they're not true, you know, like, and I want some real people to really judge them. So finally I got the opportunity to actually be here and do some justice here.
All right, well, let's get to some games. It's time to go head to head. First up is Enrique from Dallas, Texas. Everything's bigger in Texas, so it won't surprise you that his team wrote a sci-fi novel as a companion piece to their game. Let's meet Team Triple V Titles and their game, Ring Runner, Flight of the Sages.
Hi, I'm Enrique.
I'm Paul.
And I'm Courtney.
And together we're Team Triple V Titles. And so here we are at the programming headquarters of Ring Runner, aka my brother Paul's room. My brother and I have been working on Ring Runner for nearly 5 years.
I'm just adding the spectator mode to our multiplayer.
Shouldn't there be a semicolon there?
Get out. I'm the programmer. I think I've written like 80,000 lines of code.
We didn't really know what we were getting into. We were complete amateurs, sort of learn as you go. It's been about just kind of launching imbecilically into things.
Do you think you can have all of the races finished by the time that we're launching?
Oh, yeah.
My fiance, Courtney, has started living with us.
I work a 9-hour day, then come back here and work more on Ring Runner. Enrique and Paul work, and then they eat, and then they work, and then they go to sleep. It's really amazing how much they work.
If anyone knows about this game, it's us, right?
When we were both, teenagers, my brother and I, we had a credit card that we borrowed from our parents. and we got into a lot of trouble playing Silent Death Online.
In 1999, my brother and I were hooked on Mythic Entertainment's space shooter, Silent Death Online. We managed to rack up a $1,000 credit card bill and were promptly grounded. We never got to play again, but we vowed to one day make a modernization of SDO and sell it for a cost that wouldn't get anyone a timeout.
Boom!
Yeah!
This game is funded by student loans mostly, and as many of you will know, those student loans turn into bills. And so we're trying to rush this game out and hopefully pay some of those loans back.
All right, so Enrique, if you win the Next Game Boss, do you plan on paying back your parents some of that money?
I sure hope so.
All right, so a good game is presented effectively and quickly. So you have 60 seconds to pitch your game to the judges. Are you ready?
Yes.
60 seconds starts now.
So Ring Runner Flight of the Sages is an indie sci-fi action RPG. We think that it's going to appeal to space shooter fans. It's got all these classic moves like barrel rolls, lasers, and rockets, but it's also got novel skills like you can summon comets, and we've got a rich stealth engine. Now, the story is 20 hours long. It's based on a sci-fi novel. It took me 7 years to write, so at least you know it's gonna be deep, if nothing else. So we got 65 customizable hulls with over 300 skills that are never made obsolete. And every skill plays differently. You can play it solo, local, co-op, online co-op, and competitively.
And time's up.
Oh, I'm sorry, I'm out of time.
This is one of those kind of games where, you know, I'll believe it when I see it, and not being cynical, because it's like, it's so much that you're throwing at us that it's like, okay.
What is the story? What's like a short synopsis of the story?
It's also a tough thing to say, but basically you wake up from some unelective brain surgery and you don't know, it's a classic sort of, you don't know who you are, you don't know where you came from. You have this voice inside your head named Nero, and he's gonna guide you through the universe and kind of discovering your destiny as well.
What is that title image with the half brain, half moon?
We just wanted to get some sort of engaging image. It is part of the story, just kind of deep in there, so I don't think you'll get to it.
All right guys, you have 2 minutes, headphones on, time to play Ring Runner.
What is the meaning behind this logo? There's like a huge map you can
see. I went to that one. This is very fun.
This is crazy. And there's such different games.
Yeah,
there's a lot of different game modes. I mean, it's a massive, massive game.
All right, judges, no. Time's up.
It's not my kind of game, you know, but you know.
What can you say? It's amazing. Very well done.
I probably would like to see some kind of streamlined mode just to get me experience a wide variety of those, like right away.
Thank you, Enrique.
Thank you.
Thanks a lot.
Thank you.
My one biggest concern is the game is so big. You know, it's been both the boon and the bane of our game.
Our next competitor is Sangwoo Hong, representing Team Space Crabs from Marina Del Rey, California, which incidentally is known for its Outer Rim crab cakes. Their game is called Space Crabs Must Die.
Welcome to my place. I live here by myself. It's just big enough for a single guy like me. I got close to getting married a couple of times, but I don't have time for that right now. I gotta make games. My name is Sangwoo. My team is Team Space Crabs, and our game is Space Crabs Must Die.
So for the boss crabs, they're like a giant lobster.
Right, the mother of all crab. Me being a small indie developer, mostly on my own with some friends, I think the dream situation for Space Crabs Must Die would be to make it onto Steam and, you know, sell a bazillion copies.
VENABLE!
So do we still want to strap some bombs on the suicide crabs? I've always wanted to be a developer just because I would just come up with random ideas and they get kind of stuck in my head. So if I don't get them out, they kind of bug me, so.
You got crabs, which means a crab just touched your ship, and then break out the butter sauce.
You don't want crabs touching your ship. Committing to a game like this is fun when you're working with your friends. I'm having to do it on the side. I got a full-time job.
I love the fact that my friends are basically working on this with me. It would be great if I could actually pay them to do it.
Take your gi.
Oh, yeah, right. You never know what kind of trouble I'm going to get into. Okay, what else?
The game.
There you go.
I'm out of here.
Safe journeys. Make your crabs proud.
I will. I think I could keep this up for a couple more years, but yeah, something's gotta give. Hopefully, Space Crabs Must Die. Hello, judges.
Welcome, thank you for having us.
Why crabs?
Well, so, there was a bunch of games that had Must Die in the title coming out.
Okay.
And so we're like, so what's the funniest thing we could possibly think of that must die? And, you know, one thing led to another, and Space Crabs was it for us, so.
All right, so the same rules apply to you. You have 60 seconds to pitch your game to the judges, starting now.
Space Crabs Must Die is a retro-style shooter inspired by the golden age of shooters on consoles and arcade games. And in it, you play as Captain Space Monkey, who, along with his space cadet friends, are out to save the Earth from the evil spacecraft empire. As Captain Space Monkey, you use a variety of weapons and power-ups to fight your way through wave after wave of spacecrafts who are out to destroy you. You also use Spacecrafts Must Die's unique mouse-driven controls to fly circles around your enemy as you beat them up. You wouldn't want to play the game any other way. Going forward, the idea is to put more game segments inspired by other retro games, and to add a lot more weapons. That's it. That's my presentation.
Thank you, Sangwoo.
Did I make 60 seconds? I hope so.
You made it. Don't worry about it.
Okay, thank you.
Actually, it turns out you did not make the 60 seconds. You're off, but it was nice to meet you. I love the art style. I love games like this. It's going to have to be really fun to make up for what at least currently looks like an absolute void of innovation and newness.
I've played a lot of these side-scrolling bullet hell shooter games. My favorite is Death Smiles. What do you think it is about your game that will take me away from Death Smiles and play this one instead?
Part of the problem with old-school shooters is that the joystick controls, it's very hard for most people to play the game that way. So that's why I actually have a mouse control where you can place your ship anywhere you want to go and shoot the enemy from the front, from the back, up, down, whatever you like. And so it kind of frees you up from the aggravation of having to fight the controls, basically.
Like David, I really liked the art style there. It just gave me a lot of like nostalgia about this very lighthearted fun. Now I want to see whether the mechanics brings back that memory as well.
Well, I guess we'll find out once you have a chance to play the game.
All right, thank you, Sangwoo. Our judges have been briefed on the game controls. They now have 2 minutes to play Space Crabs Must Die.
Let's kill some crabs.
Round 20.
Oh. Mega Bomb! Mega Shield!
Mega Bomb!
Get that crabs. I'm picking up lots of coins. What will that eventually get me?
You'll eventually be able to buy power-ups and light extra lives and weapons and all sorts of stuff in the menu.
All right, judges, time's up.
When my spacecraft was destroyed, I actually have a parachute. I wonder, why do I need that in space?
Really? Really we're having this conversation?
Yeah.
Goodness gracious. Okay, fair enough.
I won and I got an A+.
Yes. Great.
No, I didn't mean to interrupt the question. I'd love to hear the answer. I mean, I'm assuming it's because it's humorous, it's fun, it's silly, it's...
Yes, eventually we're going to build the Captain Spacecraft on all his friends, and your camera should zoom in as they're, you know, freaking out or... they're giving themselves thumbs up and all that kind of stuff.
All right, thank you guys, and thank you, Sangwoo. Good luck to you and your team.
Well, thanks for having me. I'm feeling very good. I had a pretty good presentation, I think, and hopefully the judges would like what I had to show.
All right, judges, now you've played both games. It's time to make a decision about who moves on to round two.
I thought it would be very easy to tell which one to pick, but Spacecraft Must Die. I like the feeling of the art, you know, and the fun.
There is a lot of funny potential with spacecrafts.
But it seems like a Rerunner, there's just more robust features.
The guy came in here and sold us on a vision. I mean, it's the perfect pitch, you know, switcheroo. It's like, I'm gonna make the biggest movie ever. It's gonna be great. Here's the check. It's like, where's the script? Where's the actor? What's the director? It's like, I had more fun with Space Crabs than I did with Ring Runner, although Ring Runner was substantially more ambitious.
Anyone's gonna be able to pick up Space Crabs and have a great time, immediately know how to play, no confusion whatsoever. We had confusion with Ring Runner.
Once you were in Ring Runner, were you having a great time?
Yes.
Okay.
I was having a great time.
Maybe if you really dive in deep and really experience, you know, this novel in written for 7 years and really get something deep, which I don't know how deep that is, you know?
The vision is so much better with Ring Runners. But the question is, what proof do we have that he's come anywhere close to achieving it?
Basically, we're competing the two based on likability.
And what has the most potential as a game that you would want to stand behind and say, I helped bring that to people's attention?
All right.
Man, this is tough.
All right, here is the decision.
The fate of our two game designers rests in your hands. Let's bring them out for our first elimination.
Welcome back.
Sanwoo, Enrique, for one of you, it will be game over. For the other, it's on to the final four. All right, let's hear from our judges.
So, I don't know if you guys have seen each other's game already, but you're both working on a space shooter. I'm a passionate game designer. I know how hard it is to have someone to say no to you or say your game is over. Enrique, your game is just so massive that, you know, I just feel like I don't really have enough information. It seems to be a very massive game. Sanwoo, what I really liked is the immediate fun like I have right away. And I can see this game become very, very accessible to a mass audience and, you know, could be a big hit. What I don't know yet, which I wanted to know more, is how is the game going to progress and evolve?
Sanwoo, I mean, your game is hilarious, and I think it has so much potential for even more hilarity. I mean, it's spacecrafts and they must die. Ring Runner, wow, that's a lot there. We kind of got stuck in the opening credits a bit, but there's no doubt that there is insane potential there. So, well done, both of you.
I think your game is instantly fun. The art style is cool, the spirit of it is cool. I really like your game. Ring Runner, I have no way of knowing if you're full of shit and you're just a good salesman with a lot of flashy graphics, or if you've ultimately given us what could be the next great game.
All right, the judges have had their final word. It's time to find out who will be moving on to round two and a shot at $10,000. Congratulations, team. Triple B. Congratulations on making it to the next round, and Sanwoo, I'm sorry, you will not be the next game boss.
Thank you.
I feel sad, but you know, that I couldn't make it to the next round, but I'm very hopeful. You know, they had very good things to say about the game, so.
Well, I'm not sure that I even believe it yet, and I know it was a really close decision. They kept us guessing right until the end. It was definitely nerve-wracking.
Wow, two epic space games, one epic battle, and we're just getting started. We'll be back next week with two more teams, two more games, and one more shot at being the next game boss. For David Jaffe, Lisa Foyles, and Genova Chen, I'm Naomi Kyle. See you all next week. Next time on Game Boss, it's a runner versus a reader.
I love the flavor, I love the idea, I hope it actually plays as fun as it looks.
Team Death Boulder versus Team Rose Gold.
The anticipation of not knowing what's gonna happen is just really big.
These mechanics can be put together in a more coherent way.
Get people right into the game quicker instead of having them drop off.
Did the judges make the right call? Go to the link below to vote for your favorite game and read more about our judges and contestants.